I noticed you use Twitter quite a lot. You've each got an account and also one between you.
Yes. We're both, although there's a lot happening on it and we write a lot, we're not very good at it. We have to actually make ourselves do it. That's why you often see when we tweet or Facebook or Instagram or all those online things, you see that one of us does it and then Taylor and me does it and then the other one will retweet everything and it'll all happen at once. You know, there'll be a massive surge of the same thing because we're like, right, we should do it now, sit down, make ourselves do it. But it does help music, getting your music out there these days, because everyone's on it. Everyone uses those social media sites.
So do you still perform individually? Are you still putting out tracks individually?
Yeah, we still do. Samuel Taylor is Taylor's full stage name as a soloist, and he's hoping to release an album next year. And myself, under the name Jodie Marie, I'm hoping to release an album next year as well. So it's going to be a busy year because we're also hoping to do a duet album as well. And I guess it's just getting our music out there. I love working as a soloist as well as doing duets, and I know Sam's the same. And there's you get different things from both. And because I've only ever performed as a solo artist, I think getting together with Sam and doing this duet project is something so different and exciting, and I love working with Sam. He's a right laugh. Shame that he can't be here for this interview as well.
Well, he's busy with another one, isn't he?
That's why there's two of us, so we can split up and do things.
yeah. Well, that's fair enough.
Yeah.
So when you talk about CDs, I'm puzzled at the moment what forms a CD, because I notice Bad Moon Rising is a single out in December.
Yes.
But it's also a track on the EP that's available at the moment.
Yes. Tilt the Moon, our EP, has four tracks. Three of them are our own original songs, which we've written, and then one of them being Bad Moon Rising, which is obviously a Creedence Clearwater song. But we released our first single, All I Need, when we released the EP, which is on the EP itself. And we've gone to release the second track off the EP now, so I think you can...
So what does that mean? See, I'm really lost as to what a single is and when the CD comes out, what difference it makes, because presumably all the tracks are available individually for download.
Yeah, so people can actually get it now. It's available out there on iTunes and things like that. But I guess it's being released as such in December to radios and things. It's being serviced to radio stations, so hopefully it'll be played. Fingers crossed.
Yeah, it's weird though, isn't it? Because I've just got the impression that YouTube has taken over, really.
I guess, or
SoundCloud, because I know you've got a very strong presence on SoundCloud. You made several tracks available there to listen to.
Yeah.
And it just seems to me that Well, certainly us as a radio programme, we just look at YouTube, what's available there.
Yeah.
And maybe record companies will send us tracks, but it doesn't happen very often.
Yeah.
It's more likely we'll see through Twitter that a track's available, and then you look at YouTube and it's there.
Yeah, I guess it's more accessible in a way. You know, everyone's on YouTube. You can spend hours trailing through YouTube. And I guess with the visual side of it as well, it also helps. And we do have a couple of videos on YouTube for our first single.
So I could only find one.
All I Need is our first single, and that's